The Slow the Flow Grants Initiative and campaign started as an idea to engage the community in solving some problems that we were seeing on the refuge. Being an estuary, I was realizing that a lot of our issues came from our adjacent lands. A lot of the runoffs and water uses upland affects us. So the idea was that we needed landowners to actually take ownership of some of these issues and come up with real solutions.
I never realized what the extent of the vases was. For me, this is just a game. To me, when I find a nice plant buried in weeds, it's a treasure. And it's fun, it's a treasure hunt. And then when I get to that point, you know, instead of me doing it, you know, maybe nieces and, you know, my daughter.
I do it for my kids because they're going to grow up to just know what a native plant is. They're going to grow up to just assume that this is how you do things. The most important thing for the river is getting that impervious surface out. And I hadn't planned on removing this much plastic because I didn't know there was this much plastic on the property. All those plants along the road were not there a year ago. It was just empty space. I have seen hummingbirds feeding all along there every day with my kids, watching them feed.
Was grass, poorly growing grass that required a good deal of water to just maintain it. And what we did was removed the top layer of that grass and put down compost, which was an organic compost. We did a lot of homework on the plants. Together we referred to the book and tried to make sure that we had plants that were native to the area, and that's what we selected. We had the idea of putting boulders here because we thought that the boulders would highlight some of the plants, pick up the color in the rocks at the second level, and the color of the house.
Now that we have our first group of landowners that actually took the grant money and accomplished amazing things in their backyard, next year we can actually use them as demonstration projects, and we can show people what can be done, you know, with very little money and a relatively short amount of time.
We live so close to the river, so it's something that I think of, like, every time it rains, watching all of the water go down there, washing the pollution. It's just something that you think about. For this project, it seemed like it was one that was small in area and scope, but could be inspirational to the people around you. We basically replaced our entire patio, which was made of asphalt, with these new permeable pavers. To be able to put these in was really exciting because we hadn't anticipated kind of being able to use the new technology.
This whole project has been a huge learning experience for me. Some of the grant applicants have been a wealth of information. They have, you know, researched so much on their own, and they're sharing it with each other and sharing it with me. One of my interns, Melissa Lesh, she actually pulled together this amazing rain barrel workshop for the public. Kind of a really unexpected outcome of this project.
You just start here. You can inspire people, or at least tell your story.